Hi everyone, I'm Simon.
I'm Cheryl.
We're the two Canadians locked up in Bologna, Italy, in the lockdown. Just want to let everyone know that we're doing fine. No problems here with us at all. Our supermarkets are still open. Yep. We've been able to get food whenever we need it. I guess the biggest news is that you now need papers to go out of the house to explain or to justify leaving the house. So it's possible you're going to get stopped by the police or the Carabinieri.
Yeah.
And if you can't explain why you're out, you could get a big fine or jail time.
Yep. They're being very serious, very strict.
Yep. So yeah, we appreciate all the messages we've been getting from people. We appreciate your concern. Mm. Really, we're fine. No problems.
And for now, everything seems okay. We're just, you know.
You can keep checking because we like to hear from you guys.
Yeah.
Please keep checking because it's been really nice catching up with friends in Canada and around the world, Korea.
Yep.
And another big story is the prison. There were 22 prison riots last Sunday, and over 70 prisoners escaped. 11 apparently still on the loose as of Wednesday. They rioted when family visitations were cut off, and the speculation is that their outside drug supply was cut off. So some of the prisoners died from overdoses when they broke into the prison infirmary. And yeah, died of drug overdoses. 6,000 prisoners in total rioted, and I think 40 guards were injured. So that's pretty wild. There's a prison just a mile from our school where we teach, and on Monday I heard helicopters circling around the area, and I was like, are they searching for somebody? And a student told me what had happened, and yeah, that's pretty wild.
Yeah. Yeah, that seems like a strange thing. But other than that, not really any rioting. People, the Italians seem very calm, very collected. They're being respectful. They're being kind. I mean, for the most part, they're being pretty kind to each other. Everyone's respectful at the supermarket, waiting in line, standing their meter apart.
We saw people standing a meter apart when we went to check out the supermarket on Friday. And I don't think anyone was enforcing that. But everyone was respecting that.
Yeah,
so,
people are being really good.
That's interesting to see. It's good.
Yep. Kind of, Italians are really social people, so I'm sure this is difficult for all of them, but, they've been like doing fun things like, singing out their balconies if they live in an apartment building or something. That's really cool. There's a lot of good videos circulating now on YouTube and stuff. And,
If you haven't seen them, check it out.
Balcony serenades or balcony concerts. They're great. We saw one. We saw one in person on Friday night.
Yeah. Behind our apartment, we heard this music. So, and we've heard them play several times over the last few years. And we've never been able to find them. So finally we found where they're coming from. And yeah, it was great. We were hoping they're going to put on another concert soon.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's been cool.
Yeah.
Other positive news is without the ferry traffic and the cruise ships, you know, which is a big loss to the economy, of course. But the water is clearing in Venice.
Venice is clean. Cleaner for the first
time. Dolphins are coming back in Sardinia to a port where usually they don't because of the pollution.
And the ships and all the,
right,
all the human traffic.
The air quality is improving. Emilia-Romagna, where we live, has one of the worst air qualities in all of Europe.
It's the worst in Europe, I think.
Which we didn't know before we moved here and has really never affected us. It's never affected us that we've noticed.
Yeah.
But
we'll see if it's dramatically different in the next week. Yeah.
Yeah. So
there you go.
Yeah, we've been doing some Skype calls with our friends in Bologna, and that's been really nice, and friends in other parts of the world. Other news, I guess the last time we were out was Friday. We've been in all weekend.
Although we went outside for a little exercise and sunshine, and we read a book outside. It was nice, but just like in the backyard.
That's right.
Not really leaving home, but
yeah. So I'm just going to, just quickly before we end, I'm going to just ask, so Cheryl, how did you feel when this started and how has it changed and how are you feeling about it now?
It's definitely ramped up very quickly. I mean, I guess when they first said that there were people here, I've watched enough movies, outbreak films and whatnot, pandemic type of of sci-fi films to figure that, yeah, that it was going to come to this. But yeah, I mean, it's scary if I watch the news,
But
but
we don't turn on the
we
TV.
try just to watch what's important for us to learn and then
Yeah, either we see it
not
on
panic.
Facebook or YouTube, or we look up something specific, but we don't turn on the TV because we know it's just going to be. It's like when you look up a disease or you wonder, you have some health problem, you look it up, and everything tells you you're going to die, right? So.
No, I mean, I still feel okay at this point. I'm really hoping we don't get sick, but right now I don't know. I'm kind of lazy. I kind of like sitting at home, so
Yeah.
it's,
We've been able to work from
dare I
home.
say, it's a little bit fun.
Yeah. We're very lucky. We've been able to work from home, and a lot of other people are in much worse shape or situations than we are.
I'm glad we have each other.
We're
I'm glad we're not
absolutely,
alone.
absolutely.
I might be going crazy if I was alone.
Some people are stuck all by themselves with no companion animals, no nobody. So that's
Oh,
got to be tough.
I'd definitely be like trying to coax a pigeon in to live with me or something if I was
Right,
alone,
right.
but
I'll be honest that when this started, as soon as I heard that the numbers went up in Italy, I was like, okay, it's gonna start, it's gonna come here, and I just started being antisocial
understood.
immediately. I was like,
Yeah,
I
thank
don't
you.
want to get sick because we didn't really know what the conditions were then,
Right.
and I didn't want to pass it on to anyone else. We stayed pretty calm, but it's been like your mind kind of goes in circles, and yeah, overall we've been pretty calm about it, and we're not really concerned. We just don't want to pass it on to anybody else if
Yeah,
we had
we want
something
to
and didn't
help. We
know.
want to help the situation if we can.
Yeah. So our message would be, if this hasn't affected you yet, regardless of what you think about it, it's going to affect you, so it's best to prepare for it. Get in what you need for 2 to 3 weeks or more, and just be nice to each other. Keep yourself positive, keep yourself entertained,
Yourself healthy,
keep
eat a
yourself
lot of fruits
healthy.
and
Boost your
vegetables.
immune system with
Yeah,
healthy
can't
fruits
hurt.
and vegetables,
Can't hurt.
And yeah, give other people a break and just try to be nice to each other right now, because we all need that right now to be there for each other rather than bring each other down. So thanks, stay healthy and happy.
Love to you all and
Love to you
best
all from
wishes.
Italy, and
We'll check in soon.
keep sending those messages. Let us know how you're doing.
Yep.
Ciao.
Ciao.